WCTW presents Sesame Street Show 3040.
Boy, am I excited today. Guess what? One of the greatest actors in the whole world, Sir John Feelgood, is coming to Sesame Street. Oh, I hope he shows up soon. Ooh, I hear something. Oh, just a dog. Hi, doggy. Nice doggy. Hey, you're not a dog. Why, you're...
Sir John Feelgood, actor. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Gosh, you know, for a moment there, I thought you were really a dog.
And do you know why you thought I was a dog?
No, why?
Because I was pretending.
Wow, you know, I've seen pretending before. But that's the best pretending I've ever seen.
That's what a great actor does. Pretends to be something else. And I, Sir John Feelgood, have a natural gift. I was born to pretend. In fact, I can even pretend being born.
Imagine that. What's that? It sounds like a baby. What baby is there around here?
That was no baby. That was me.
It was?
Yes, pretending. Thank you. Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Wow, that was great. You know, I love to pretend too. Watch this.
A horse, very good. Mm-hmm. I see you have the gift, my talented feathered friend, but I think you can be even more horsey.
More horsey?
Imagine yourself on a field of green, lush grass.
Yeah, I'm imagining that.
You love to run and prance, the wind blowing in your mane.
Yes, I feel the wind blowing in my mane.
Your horse tail whipping in the wind.
Swish, swish, swish. Yes, I feel so horsey.
That's pretending.
Thank you. Oh, let's do some more, Sir John.
I wish I could, but I'm too tired. Much, much too tired. I must sleep. Sleep, perchance, to dream.
I guess great actors need their sleep.
I'm not really sleeping.
Oh, I thought you were.
That's pretending. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. You touched me deeply. Thank you.
Wow. What a great actor.
Thank you so much.
Here's Faye. Hi, Faye. Faye is going to turn into a... Can you guess?
What's that?
It looks like a green elephant.
Maybe it's a different colored elephant. It has different spots on it.
Yeah, that's what it is, baby.
It has a trunk.
Oh, I know what that is. It's a deer.
It's a moose.
No, it's not.
It could be a cow with antlers.
It looks like a deer with big fluffy ears to me. It's a toad.
A toad?
Or maybe it's a frog. It's Kermit the dog.
Oh, my dad works in a factory and mommy does too. And when they get home, oh brother, there's still lots more work to do. So we always help each other. Yeah, we always help each other. Mom helps dad doing the dishes and the doing of the wash. I help mom do some gluing and the taking out the trash. All the washing and trashing was never more fun. 'Cause when we all do it, it soon gets done.
Oh, my dad works in an office and my mom works at home. Dad works hard to earn some money, but each night when he gets home, he says,
doing some mixing and then mopping up the floor.
Help dad with the fixing out the squeaky kitchen door.
All the mixing and fixing was never more fun. 'Cause when we all do it, it soon gets done. Daddy works in a grocery and I go to school alone. In the sun or stormy weather, but on weekends when we're home, we always work together. Always work together. Dad helps me doing my homework and the making of my bed. I help dad with the shopping and the baking of the bread. All the shaking and baking was never more fun. 'Cause when we all do it, it soon gets done. It soon gets
tip.
Don't be a drip.
Oh, the wind is starting to blow.
How do you know?
We're going to and fro.
Oh, no.
Larry, go slow.
I'm going below.
I know, I'll row.
Oh, whoa.
What's wrong?
It won't be long.
Oh, I think we're strong.
Oh, we're starting to sink.
That's what I think.
Our chances are slim.
Don't listen to him.
But the problem is grim.
We'll all have to swim.
Is all you can do yelp?
No, I'm calling for help.
Best idea all day.
That's what I say.
Help! Don't delay. We're over this way.
Mayday!
Bigger, mooier, let out all your cow feelings that are deep inside of you.
Okay. Moo!
Perhaps you saw me as the lovesick cow in Moostruck. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Oh. What a moo! It was like there was a real cow here.
Yeah, that's why Sir John Feelgood is one of the greatest actors in the world.
Wow. Oh, Sir John, please, do you think that I could pretend to be something too?
Of course. Look at you. You're magnificent. Every shaggy inch cries out, actor. You're dripping with acting talent.
I am.
You shall pretend to be
a mouse.
Snuffy? A mouse?
Sir John, I'm a little bit big. I don't know if I could pretend to be anything as small as a mouse.
And why not? You're alive, aren't you? You breathe and grow?
Yes.
So does a mouse. And when you're hungry at night, do you not enjoy dinner?
I love dinner.
So does a mouse. And on a snowy, wintry day, do you not feel cold and shivery?
Yes, I do.
So does a mouse. Now, imagine yourself a hungry, shivery little mouse. A mouse
squeaking for a bit of cheese. Squeak. Squeak.
Gee, I hear a mouse. Is there a hungry mouse around here?
No, Bert. That was me.
Ah, I thought you were really a mouse.
And you know why, don't you?
That's pretending.
Precisely.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. You are too kind. What? You want to hear it again? Oh, if you insist. Thank you. Thank you.
hardly a sound. I look in the mirror and I see something round. It's a circle looking me in the face. A circle filling up some space. A circle with my face. It's a circle. I go to the window and take a look outside. I notice the window. It has four equal sides. It's a square and it's made up of glass. A square left in sunlight pass. A square that's filled with glass. It's a square. They are everywhere. My clock's a circle and my table square. Shapes in my room, they are always there. Shapes are something we all share. I open up my door and now I'd like to report. There's a total of four sides. Two are long, two are short. It's a rectangle kind of part of the wall. A rectangle leading to the hall. This rectangle. Triangle on the lamp by the chair. I count three sides that are always there. Shapes are something we all share. Shapes in my room. Everywhere. Shapes in my room.
Says when the pumpkins are ripe, it's really fall. Sometimes I like to lie in the hammock and watch the leaves. Fall is the season that I love because you can play in the leaves. In the autumn time, the animals are very busy. They feel the cold air. You know it's time to start getting ready for winter. They gather food, raccoons, squirrels, and chipmunks. All the babies from the bird's nest have grown up and flown away. They know it's going to get cold and snow. The plants die, but their seeds are spread by the wind. They fall to the ground, and when spring comes again, to grow and grow. It's cold. The frost covers the ground. It snows and snows and snows. Very beautiful and quiet. The animals are sleeping. bears, raccoons, chipmunks, and caves, and trees, and even under the snow.
Hi-ho, Kermit the Frog here, and beside me is a telephone. Now, who can describe a telephone? In other words, who can tell me what this telephone looks like? Well, let's look at it together, shall we? Now, first of all, it's black, and it's kind of skinny in the middle, and it has a cord over here on the side, and it has a round base, and in the front, there's a big circle with a lot of little circles on it. Oh, hello, Cookie Monster.
Hi, Frog.
Yeah.
What you doing?
Well, I was asking, who can describe this telephone?
Oh, that easy.
Yeah?
Me can do.
Okay, let's see.
Me can do. Me can do.
All right.
Oh, boy, oh, boy, oh, boy. It's black.
Mm-hmm.
Good. It's skinny up here.
Yeah.
It's got a cordy thing here.
Right.
Got that kind of a roundish kind of base, mm-hmm. that thing.
Mm-hmm.
And it got the circle in front there with a whole bunch of little circles in it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's delicious.
No, Cookie Monster, a telephone is not delicious.
Oh, no?
Mm-mm.
Me right. Telephone delicious.
Open your mouth. Hello?
Kingdom that had no king. Once upon a time, there was a kingdom, and they had a king, and the king told everyone what to do.
This is your king. The apples are ripe. Pick them.
And so everybody would pick the apples, and then the king would say,
"Subjects, make applesauce."
And so everybody would make the applesauce. Then one day, the king said,
"I am tired of being the king. I've kinged enough. I'm moving to Florida to go fishing."
And so the king moved away, and the kingdom had no king.
Oh, yes, look how pretty they are.
All right. The apples look ripe. Now, what do we do?
Ask the king. He tells us what to do.
We don't have a king.
All right, I moved to Florida, remember?
Could we rent one?
Hey, Wrenchman, you better pick my apples soon before they fall off.
Could we borrow a king to tell us what to do?
No.
I know! We could tell ourselves what to do.
But how? We could vote!
Voting is one way that a lot of people can decide on something. You count all the votes, and then you do what most of the people want.
All right, listen up. How many vote to pick apples? Now raise your hand if you vote to pick apples.
Me.
That's it.
You. I do.
And you. And you. And the doggy. And your mom. Yes, of course. All right. Now, how many vote not to pick apples? Ah, more people want to pick, so
let's start picking!
Yes, good idea. Let's everyone stop picking.
And so they told themselves to pick the apples. But after they picked them, they didn't know what to do with them.
What are we going to do with all these apples? Make cider? Or make applesauce?
We need a king to tell us.
Oh, what we do, Mom?
I know this sounds crazy, but let's vote again.
Yes, good idea, Mom.
All right, how many for cider?
I like cider.
One. Good. How many for applesauce?
Oh, me.
Oh, there's much more people who want to make applesauce than cider, so let's make sauce!
That's so wonderful!
Yes,
okay. All right, everyone, grab the applesauce. Follow me!
I don't want to have...
And so they made enough applesauce to last for 10 years. But they still weren't satisfied.
Oh, look at all these apples!
Nice packaging. Very nice packaging.
All right. Sure, we all picked the apples. And sure, we all made applesauce. But we still don't have a king to tell us what to do. Oh. Eureka! We don't need a king. From now on, we'll all tell ourselves what to do. And we'll all be king.
And queen.
Right.
Yeah.
Let's vote. Okay. All in favor? Raise your hands.
Yeah.
Done. Yes. From now on, we are all kings and queens.
How about it, Your Majesty?
Oh, let's dance!
Sure.
And so they lived happily ever after.
Gloria Globe? You look terrible. What's wrong?
Oh, I don't feel very good. I'm all out of shape, and I'm losing all my color. I'm just not as green or as blue as I used to be. It's no wonder I don't feel so well. Look at all this trash! I bet I have a temperature.
Well, don't just sit there. Help her!
You know, he's right. You can help clean me up. If you just remember not to litter and put all your trash into cans, then I'd feel on top of the world in no time.
Doorways up and down the hall, wonder what's behind them all. Doors that lead to anywhere, got to ABC, what's there?
Bouncing ball, a butterfly, a bat, red, a bean, a brick, bananas, button, a bunch of broccoli, baby bottle, a book, a banana boat.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Bees.
Ask you and the kids a question?
Oh, ask away, Mr. Williams.
Well, suppose you all were playing baseball, you know, like this, like...
Oh, Butterfingers! Yeah, can't swing no better! Right in there!
And along came someone really different. I'm talking really different, like with one body, two heads, no waiting. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, horns on one head go up and horns on one head go down, and talks like this. Now, Elmo...
Huh?
Would you ask them to take a hike, or would you and the kids ask them to join you and play baseball with them?
Well, that's easy, Mr. Williams. Elmo and everybody here would ask them to play baseball with us. Right, everybody?
Sure!
Oh,
that's real nice. Babe, don't worry. That could never happen.
Play!
Play!
Ball!
Hey!
Hey, you're out!
Ladies hat, Santa Claus, I'm Santa Claus waving, funny kind.
And a really funny shoe.
And some hair.
And a nose.
And a mouth.
An eye with glasses.
I see a clown.
Sky, beasts on the land, fish in the sea, and bugs in your hand. It's the Sesame Street Creature Feature. Today's creature is the sloth.
Rest, sleepy sloth. Don't worry, just one more day. Passing time, never hurry. That's just your way. Isn't it fine? Aren't you blessed? While the whole world's whirling, you take your rest. Rest, sleepy sloth. Don't worry, you are the best.
Holding those numbers.
Oh, well, Elmo and Mary made up a little poem about the number 17. Yeah, would Gina like to hear it? It's action-packed, Gina.
Yes, I would love to. Go ahead.
Good.
Okay.
Go ahead, Mary. Here's our poem.
Okay.
I'm the number one.
Yeah. Elmo's number seven.
With a lot of space between. But when we come together. This is gonna be great. I'm the number one!
Gina, when you finish the yard sweeping and everything, I would like
Mr.
to...
Mr. Hanford! Doc!
What was that?
We're the number 17.
Oh. That was a poem.
Got a minute?
Oh, Ernie, what is it?
Look here, Bert. I have two pieces of apple pie, Bert. Would you like a piece of apple pie?
Oh, boy, would I? Yes, yes, please.
Oh, okay. Let's see. Let me just look at these for a minute. Okay,
smell
Bert.
Smell that apple pie.
Yeah, you take that piece there, Bert, and I'll take this piece here.
Excuse me, Ernie. Ernie, you gave me the small piece.
Well, that's true, Bert. That is the small piece there, and this is the big piece, and I gave you that piece, and I think I'll keep the big piece myself.
Ernie, that is not very polite.
Well, how do you mean, Bert?
Well, I mean, if I had two pieces of pie, mm-hmm. I'd offer you the big piece and take the small one for myself.
Well, Bert, you have the small piece, Bert.
Some of the words that begin with I, they get to be quite tricky, like intersection and illegal, irritate and icky.
Beep, beep. Beep, beep.
Many words that begin with I are longer than itchy and into. There's impossible and incredible and important too. The letter I is quite a pip. I think I'll take him on my trip. We'll have some fun and do a flip. Into my car away we'll zip. I'm glad to be with the letter I, cause he's so irresistible.
Beep, beep. Beep, beep.
Thank you.
ever have a dog, Uncle Al?
I sure did, Andy. Once when I was just a baby. Actually, I was much older. Yes, I was your age. But I wasn't as tall. And I was fatter. Anyway, I was running down the street. No, I was walking up the street. No, I was sitting on the curb. And this dog came up to me. Yes, this big black dog came up to me. Wait, it wasn't a dog at all. It was a horse. Yes, a horse. I never had a dog. I had a horse. Want me to tell you about my horse?
No, thanks.
About the pigeon.
Oscar, got a nice bag of trash here for you.
Yeah, just put it there, Gordon.
Oscar? What's the matter? You seem kind of sad.
Yeah. You might as well go away, Gordon. It's nothing you can help me with.
Well, try me.
You? Well, you see, if you really got to know, Grungetta's away. Mm-hmm. There's no one around to give me an enjoyable, grouchy argument.
Well, if it'll make you feel any better, I'll argue with you.
You?
Yeah, sure. So says who? Yeah, take a hike. Scram! Get out of here!
What's that supposed to be?
Well, I'm trying to argue with you. I'm acting like a grouch.
Acting? Don't give up your regular job, Gordon. You are no actor. Huh.
Perhaps I can help.
Who's the guy with the neat little hanky?
Oscar, this is Sir John Feelgood, one of the greatest actors in the world. Say, if anybody can act like a grouch, he can.
Perhaps you saw me in Two Grouches of Verona.
No.
I played both grouches. Thank you. You're very kind.
Well, why don't you just take a little hike?
Oh, yeah? Who made you the king of grouches?
Well, what's it to you?
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Double yeah with sardine oil.
Oh, yeah? Fooey.
Fooey, fooey, fooey.
Ding dong, you're wrong.
Ding dong, ding dong, you're even more wrong. And nya, 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 nya.
Well, nya, 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 you.
Well, you happy now, Oscar?
Yeah, you know, this guy knows how to act like a grouch.
Yeah.
I got one more thing to say to you. Yuck!
You call that a yuck? Try this on for size. Yuck!
Whoa, what a yuck. That's grouchy.
That's pretending. Thank you. Thank you. It means so much to me. Thank you. You're very kind.
Well, wait a minute. Why'd you stop there? You were making me happy.
Oscar, I guess the performance is over now.
Thank you. Oh, thank you. Yes, thank you. It means so much. Thank you.
Wow. Oscar, they loved you.
Me?
Yeah, they think you were pretending to be a grouch, too.
But I wasn't pretending. Hey, I wasn't pretending. I am a grouch.
Oscar, they think you're a great actor.
What's the matter with you people? I'm not acting. I really am a grouch. Wow.
Oscar, I hope this isn't going to make you feel sad again.
Are you kidding? I've never been happier. I've got all these people to argue with. I'm a grouch, you hear me? I'm a grouch!
Thank you, thank you. Yes, thank you so much.
Wow.
15, 16, 17, 17.
Buffalo. Bag. Balloons. Box.
The letter B.
Now it's empty.
Place looks full to me.
Now it's empty.
But now it's full.
Empty.
Full.
Empty.
Full.
Empty.
Hey, where did all the people go?
I don't know.
I miss you, Casmali. Welcome again to Chez Nomi, restaurant of the Cima Stars.
Thank you, Pierre. Thank you. And I hope you have lots of chairs, Pierre. Because today, I, Guy Smiley, America's favorite game show host, am taking my entire studio audience to lunch.
Yeah! Yes!
Yes, I am. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Yes.
Very good, Monsieur Smiley, but I must know how many people are in the audience.
But why, Pierre? Why?
Because we may not have a table with enough chairs.
Oh.
But I think we do.
Yeah. Oh, good. All right. All right, studio audience, step up and be counted. Just step right up.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
One step right through.
15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28.
Come on, move it, move it.
All right, all right. 29, 30. 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39.
There are 39 in my studio audience!
Yeah!
Well, Pierre?
You're in luck! I do have a table for 39! Table 17, yes.
Pierre, didn't you forget something?
What, Monsieur Smiley?
You forgot to count me!
You are right, Monsieur. Yes, the audience was 39, and you guys, Smiley, made 40.
Wonderful. Thank you. I'll just go in and sit down.
Oh, no. You may not go in and sit down.
But why not?
There is no chair for you. We have a table for 39, but we do not have a table for 40.
But no. I'm taking them to lunch. That's my audience in there.
Reservation for O'Brien?
Yes. One moment, please. It's okay. I will send you the check. Yes, Mr. O'Brien, please.
Mr. O'Brien, wouldn't you like to sit with Guy Smiley, America's favorite
please
game show host?
Talk to the customer. Oh, yes. Miss Simon, nice to see you. Your usual table. Go right in,
aren't you an old friend of mine?
No.
Please, don't talk to the customers. You'll frighten them.
Pierre, I could have lunch with the waiter.
Come back.
Perhaps I could just sit on the plants, perhaps.
What is it? A frog? Yes, it's a frog.
And now, one of the greatest actors in the world, Sir Jon Feelgood.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Will do us the honors of saying goodbye.
As only a great actor can.
Of course. Music, please. Sesame Street was brought to you today by the letters B.
Wow. Was that a B or not a B?
And I... And by the number 17. Thank you. Too kind, really. Thank you.
It's too bad you have to go, Sir John.
Yeah, but I must. I have to feed my pet chicken.
You have a pet chicken?
Doesn't everyone? Oh, I hear him clucking for me now.
You do? Wow. I hear the chicken. I hear it, Sir John. You hear the chicken? Oh, wait a minute. You're not Sir John Feelgood's chicken. You're Sir John Feelgood.
That's pretending. Wow. Thank you.
Didn't you think he was a chicken, Gene? Oh, look. Even these chickens think he's a chicken.
Thank you. It means so much to me. Thank you. Years ago, I laid quite an egg in Iowa. Thank you.
Wow. What an actor. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.
Funding for this program is provided in part by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting and by public television stations and their contributors.
This is PBS.